things I did during the first lockdown, I went to Uplift on through Zoom a couple of days, which was it really helped me realize that like there's still like good stuff in the world.
So during the lockdown to socialise, we had the Zoom calls. So with Tracy with Car Connect, we were doing weekly FaceTimes every Sunday. So we sat in our kitchen and we were drinking tea on the other end of the phone to have still that. It was almost like it was face to face. And with my friends, we had these Zoom meetings every day. Like from the minute we woke up to the minute we went to bed, we were on the phone constantly.
Well, I spent a lot more time with my family, and we actually had got a puppy in December 2019, I think. And yeah, so we got to spend a lot more time with her.
So I remember when we were first allowed to sort of, like go near people but socially distance, we would like sit outside either my garden or your garden, like your front garden. You would sit like across the road on a wee deck chair with your blanket and your food, and we'd just sit and talk for like a good 3 hours.
Part of why I say they were doing Zoom calls of men's groups, so like they're catching up with how's your week and like if there's any if you're struggling with anything. It made it better by just talking to people and having a laugh with like people.
And then we also did like we at the very start, because obviously Zoom was like a big thing and everyone was like, let's get on Zoom. I remember one night I was on with my school friends and then it just set it up with every single mutual friend of that person being in. So I remember you were in and then more of our other friends, like Amy and James, ended up
Yeah,
being
I
in with
was
school
like you
friends.
just messaged me one day being like, hey, do you want to be out of this Zoom call? And I was like, I'm literally doing nothing else, go for it.
I read loads of books and FaceTimed friends quite a lot, and we just talked about we didn't really think it'd be that serious, but then when it got more serious, we started to talk more, and we planned all these vacations and stuff we would go on, and it was funny.
And then also every Saturday on Zoom, I had my stage school, Uplift Performing Arts, which was that was like really good on Saturdays because it was genuinely just a lot of fun because we got to do singing, dancing, and acting.
Yeah, during the first lockdown, when it was announced through Uplift we were still going to do classes online through Zoom, that helped because it still gave me something to look forward to every week, which for me felt good.
So during our Zoom calls, we would have been doing quizzes. So we had like our weekly prom week. So we would have dressed up, or we would have had like one where we were wearing silly costumes. We would have been doing online games. It just depended on what we wanted to do. Like every week there was something different, and we were doing quizzes, and it was just constantly trying to make it positive.
It was quite emotional, actually.
It
We were
was,
all
because
like,
I was like, I literally haven't seen any of you for like
we
6 months.
were like, I miss you.
I miss you so much, because like you were the only one I'd seen, because like all of our other Uplift friends, they live in like different areas,
Laura
like
and Green
Laura and
Island.
Green Island and all. Like we're the only two that kind of live remotely close to each other. So yeah, it was really, really weird seeing them after all that time.
And it actually got me like willing to get up and do something. And part of it as well was we still got to do videos of ourselves for the tribute show. Like that had to be cancelled, but we were able to bring our own thing that we wanted to play for the show, even if it was just for social media. And that was something I really enjoyed doing.
Now, here comes the music.
You've got a beat for me?